How can I send an attachment if it's blocked by my recipient's email program? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Question is actually pretty simple. How can I send someone an attachment if it's blocked by their copy of Outlook? This actually applies to basically any recipient email program or email service. The bottom line here, of course, is that, well, attachments are risky. The issue is that attachments are right now the number one way that malicious software makes its way onto individual users' machines. People open up attachments that they shouldn't. Email programs may try to block many kinds of attachments. So the issue becomes one not of trying to force your attachment, your existing attachment, through your recipient's email program, but rather, what are the ways you can work around whatever those restrictions are? We may not even know what those restrictions are to begin with, so what I have for you are some ideas. Alternatives to using attachments. Number one, you know what? Does it even have to be an attachment? I run across this all the time where somebody writes up something into a Word document and then attaches the Word document to an email. Is there any reason that whatever was in that document could not just have been in the body of the email? Could it not have been the message? If that's an option, that avoids this problem entirely by not using an attachment to begin with. Can you use another format? For example, if .docx files are being blocked by your recipient, maybe you can save it to PDF or print to PDF and then send the PDF instead. That has a number of other advantages because it's guaranteed then that your recipient will see what it is you think they'll see, but more importantly, they may actually get the file. Number three, zip it. By that I mean use a zipping program or the zip functionality built into Windows itself and zip your document, in this case our example, a .docx document, into a zip file. In many cases where the original file type, .docx, or in often cases .exe files for obvious reasons, can't make it through a recipient's email program, encasing it in a zip file not only makes it smaller, of course, but actually sometimes will bypass those kinds of filters. Rename it. Sometimes it's as simple as renaming it. For example, if you take your .docx file and rename it, oh, I don't know, a .leo file, that may be enough to get past the block. Then your recipient simply renames it back to the .docx file that you started with, and off they go. And finally, you know what? Don't use email to transfer the document at all. Instead, upload whatever this file is to cloud service like Dropbox or OneDrive or any of a number of others and send a link. Not only will your email be smaller, but it won't have to go through this additional, is that attachment safe or not, vetting that many email programs will put it through. Instead, they'll be able to click on the link and access the file directly from wherever you uploaded it. Now, I have to close by pointing out that all of these restrictions, all of these blocks exist for a reason. And that reason is keeping the recipient safe. Like I said at the beginning, attachments are right now the number one way that malicious software makes its way onto people's machines. Blocking attachments is a security measure. Bypassing these measures implies that you're not trying to get malware onto your recipient's machine. Don't do that. But more often than not, make sure that what you are sending is in fact malware free. If you're passing on something that you got as an attachment, then you're putting your recipients at risk if you're forwarding it on. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/1895. I'm Leo Notenboom and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.